Are you ready to take your Excel skills to the next level? Whether you're a beginner or experienced user, mastering Excel shortcuts can save you hours and make you into a true spreadsheet wizard. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today, I want to go through the essential Microsoft Excel shortcuts. We're going to go through this in a logical order to make sure that we build the foundation on this before we get to the advanced techniques. You're going to see down below in this spreadsheet that I have open the different categories that we're going to go through. We're going to look at navigation and selection, data entry and editing, formatting and functions, working with rows and columns, data manipulation, and then I'm going to throw in some additional functions. By the end, you're going to be navigating, editing, and manipulating data in Excel with speed and confidence. Let's get started. If you would like to follow along today, I'll put a link to this spreadsheet down below in the description. Then you can test out these shortcuts as we go along. Let's start with navigation and selection. Currently, I'm just in cell B3 here, where it says Iron Man, and I want to show you to navigate quickly around a spreadsheet, use Control and the arrows. So if I hold Control down, and then I press to the right arrow, notice I jumped over to Thanos. If I hold Control down and the down arrow, now I'm down at the bottom, and Control left, I go back to the left side. So this is a quick way to navigate around the ends of your data, holding the Control and the arrow keys. If you want to select, let's say I was back in Iron Man, if I add Shift to it now. So Control, Shift, and now when I use the arrow key, so if I press down arrow key, it will select that data in that column. If I hold Control, Shift, and press the right arrow key, it will select everything to the right as well. So if I select one spot, Control, Shift, and up arrow key, you can see how it selects the data there. If you want everything selected in a hurry, use Control plus A and everything will be selected. If you're just after selecting rows or columns, try these shortcuts. For a row, hold down Shift and spacebar. If you want to select a column, use the Control and spacebar, and it will select the entire column. If you want to go to a specific cell, try Control plus G. This will come up where you can put a reference in. So if I was going to type A555, hit OK, it will jump to A555. If you want to get back to your data set, try this one. Hold down Control and the Home key, and you're going to go right back to the top. If you want to go to the end of the data, try Control and the End key, and you'll see down here, you'll go to the end of the data. If you want to navigate from worksheet to worksheet with shortcuts, use this one. Control and Page Down will move you to the right. So as I keep pressing Control and Page Down, if I want to go back the other way, I hold Control down and then press Page Up and it will go to the left. If you want to freeze your header row in place so it doesn't move, try this shortcut. Use the Alt key, and you don't have to keep holding the Alt key down. You can let it go after, but you see all the different shortcuts available. I'm going to press W. And if I look under freeze pane, that's going to be F. And then at that point, I can freeze the top row by clicking R. So if I scroll down now, notice it stays in place. If I want to undo that, I can go Alt, W, and then looking at the freeze pane again, I can hit F for unfreeze and it's unfrozen. Make sure you take advantage of using this Alt key and those other shortcuts with letters and numbers to quickly do what you want. An overlooked shortcut is just hitting enter. So what I mean by this is if I go ahead and type something in, and let's say in this case, Thor failed, I can go hit enter, and then that confirms the entry into Excel. If we're typing away and we want a new line in here, what we can do is hold Alt and keep holding Alt and press enter. Notice it gives me a new line because then I can go fill in more information. So involving multiple criminals and hostage situation. When I hit enter now, notice that everything is showing up in here. If you want to edit a cell like this one that says in progress, you could double click into it. But if you want the shortcut, use your F2, or on my keyboard, it would be function F2. And then this allows me to go into the cell. This is where I can change it. If you make something or change something that you don't want to have changed, you can undo this by using Control Z. So if I press Control Z, it undoes it. But if you've decided you actually want it, you can use Control Y to redo it. If you use comments in Microsoft Excel, here's a shortcut so you can quickly add them. Let's say I want to add something to this mission ID. I'm going to use my Shift and F2. So once I go ahead and do that, it automatically pops up where I can go and input a comment to it. And you can see how that comment is there after you add it. Copy, cutting, and pasting is similar in Excel than other programs. So we can go to a cell, we can go Control C, what will copy it, and go somewhere else, and Control V to paste it. Now, if I want to cut it, I could go to this exact same cell and go Control X. This time, when I paste it, Control V, notice it's gone. It's cut out of there. Another thing I want to point out with copying and pasting, let's say this. If I had this whole thing, I can go Control C. If I paste it over here, it pastes with the format. If you don't want to have formatting with it, I'll paste it again, but this time I'm going to hold the Shift down with the V and the Control. So Control Shift V. And notice there's no formatting to it. Let's move over to formatting and functions. And the first one I want to show you for a shortcut is how to format cells. If I want to turn this to currency, I'm going to go ahead and select this column. And at this point, I can use the shortcut Control, holding it down with the number one. It's going to open up format cells. At this point, I could pick my currency, hit OK, and I have it formatted. Let's say I want to add this up, sum up all of these training costs that I have here. There's a shortcut you can use for this. Is if I use Alt and hold down the equal sign together, it quickly gives me the sum function. So then I can hit enter and I have this all summed up. If you want to copy this sum formula or whatever formula is here to the right, if I move over into this cell and use Control R, this is copied over. So it took this formula over here and placed it in here and applied it to this column. Let's say we wanted to add some dates or time. We can quickly do this with shortcuts. If I go ahead and use Control and just use the semicolon, it will put in today's date. If you want to put in today's time or right now time, hold down the Shift with this, Control, Shift, colon, and then you're going to get the time inputted. If you want to copy any of these down, you can go sort of like the R1 that I showed you before. Let's move down. And if I use Control D, it will copy this down from the top. So we can keep going down, Control D, and it will copy it down. A couple more formatting ones I want to show you. Notice there's no dollar signs on this. If I wanted this to be have the dollar formatting, I can go ahead and use the Control Shift and hold down the dollar sign, and it will quickly add that to it. And if I want to format this into percentages, I could use Control Shift and the percent sign to quickly make those changes. Let me show you how you can work with shortcuts and columns and rows. Let's go ahead and add a new column. And I'm just going to select C here. And to quickly add a new column, what I can do is go Control Shift and plus. That adds a column. Now, I can even add multiple columns at once if I want by just selecting multiple columns and go Control Shift plus, and it will go ahead and add two since I had two selected. If we want to take away any columns, I can highlight those columns and go Control minus, and it takes them away. I can also do this with the rows. So if I selected six over here and went Control Shift plus, and it added another row, and we can do the same thing with the multiple, and we can take this away very quickly with the Control and minus. Sometimes you might want to hide sensitive data, and you might want to do this by hiding rows or columns. The shortcut for this, so if I go ahead and any row that I'm in, I can use the Control and the number 9 together, and notice it just hid that row. If I want to unhide any row, it's going to be using the Control, Shift, and 0. And when I do that, it will place it back. Same thing with columns. If I want to hide a column, I can go ahead and use the Control 0 and it's going to hide the column. If I want to unhide the column, I can use the Control Shift 0 and it will unhide the column. You can also hide multiple columns. So if I go ahead and do have two selected, I could use the Control 0 and it will hide two at a time. And then you can undo them the same way to unhide these. If you need to quickly adjust the column widths to make sure everything fits in here, let me show you how you do this with a shortcut. And you could do it one column at a time, or you could do multiple. So even if I have multiple columns selected and then use the Alt key, select H, O, and then I, it's going to quickly do the auto width of all the columns. Let's move over to shortcuts in data manipulation. The first one I want to talk about, because it's one of my favorite, is Flash Fill. So with Flash Fill, if I start typing, let's say just the first name, I want all first names down here. If I go Control E, it automatically fills this out because the shortcut is Control E for Flash Fill. You can quickly create a filter with a shortcut in Excel. So if you have data like this and you go Control Shift L, notice as soon as I do that, we have the filter up top. Then I could go and let's say filter everything in New York and then it's added. If I want it gone, the filter, I just have to toggle it back. Control Shift L again gets rid of the filter. If you want to turn your data into a table quickly, the shortcut is Control T. You'll be greeted with the Create a Table where you can pick what you need, hit OK, and you have your table. If you want to find and replace data inside a spreadsheet, what you can do is use the Control H. This will bring up Find and Replace. Find what? Let's replace New York with NYC. And we can go Replace All, hit OK. And you can see on the side, all the New Yorks are now NYC. I've hopped back to the Formatting and Functions sheet just to show you this next shortcut. These are three different formulas. And if I wanted to see all the different formulas, what formulas are on a sheet, the shortcut for this is going to be the Control key with the grave accent mark key. As soon as I go and click those two together, you're going to be able to see all the different formulas that are created on that sheet. If I toggle it again, it goes off. Let's move on to some additional shortcuts that are going to save you a lot of time. Let's do some charting. Let's say I want to have a chart based on the superhero, and I'm also going to pick units sold. If I go ahead and just pick F11, it will instantly create a chart based on that information that I selected. Notice here, it created a new tab with a chart. I can go through and customize it the way I would like. If I go back to the data here again, what happens if I didn't want it on a tab by itself, but embedded in the same sheet? So what I need to do for this one is use Alt plus F1. So when I do that, this will put the chart in this way, and I can still go through and customize it the way I'd like. You want to create a pivot table out of this data? What you need to do is go to Alt N V, and then you can see from a table or range, which is a T, and it has the table range in it because I was already selected in it, and I can just hit Enter for OK. So I have my pivot table. I just need to add the fields like superhero name, unit price, and you can see how you can start building it from there. Do you need to do some printing? You can do that in a shortcut. Let's say we have a selection we want to print. The shortcut for this is Control P. This will open up the print properties where you can go through, pick what you need, and go ahead and hit print from there. If you're done with your workbook and want to close out of it, you can use Control W. This will prompt you, if it's not saved, to go ahead and save it. If you're all done with Microsoft Excel, you can go ahead and use Alt F4 and it will close it down. I hope these shortcuts will help you out a lot and save you a lot of time. Let me know what type of shortcuts you're using that I've missed here today down below in the comments. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.